गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे इन मैथ्स वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद लेसन नंबर 5, ऑपरेशंस ऑन रैशनल नंबर्स. बिफोर डिस्कसिंग विद रैशनल नंबर्स चिल्ड्रन, फर्स्ट लेट अस गेट टू नो व्हाट आर नेचुरल नंबर्स. नेचुरल नंबर्स आर ऑलवेज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज कैपिटल एन एंड दे स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1, 2, 3, 4 डॉट डॉट डॉट. दैट मीन्स दीज डॉट्स रिप्रेजेंट चिल्ड्रन. वी डोंट नो वेयर दिस नेचुरल नंबर्स आर एंडिंग. दैट मीन्स दे आर एंडलेस. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट इज दी whole numbers. Whole numbers are represented as capital W and they start from 0. They include 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and it is endless. We don't know where it is ending. Okay. Now the next set of numbers are the integers. Integers are represented as capital I and they include set of negative integers, 0 and positive integers. Okay children, negative integers, 0 and positive integers. You can see here dot dot dot. That means from infinity, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, that means we don't know where it is ending, right? Now next are the rational numbers. Rational numbers are represented as capital Q and they are the numbers children which are expressed in the form of m upon n. M upon n means in the fraction form, where m is an integer. You can see here m is in the numerator and n is in the denominator, and m is an integer. That means it can be a positive integer or it can be a negative integer. And n is a non-zero integer, children. That means this denominator can be negative integer or positive integer, but cannot be equal to 0. See here, n is a non-zero integer means n is not equal to 0. Such numbers are called as rational numbers. So here we have examples for rational numbers. -5/9, you can see here. 7/3 is also rational number. 2. This 2 we can express as children upon form as 2/1. Okay. The next set of number we have is 0.5. It is a decimal form of number. So this 0.5 we can also have in the upon form as 5/10. So this 0.5 is also a rational number. Now next is the 4/0 children. So see now here 4 is in the numerator and see here in the denominator we have 0. But as per the condition children, the denominator should not be equal to 0. That means it is not an, this 4/0 is not an rational number. Students, let us start with practice set 22. Our first question is carry out the following addition of rational numbers. Now children, here since we have to carry out the addition of these two fractions, one thing you should keep in mind that to carry out the addition of this fraction, the denominator should be same. Here we have 36, here we have 42. So we cannot directly add this. Okay. Now second thing what you have to do is children, you have to see what is the relation between 5 and 36. Okay, there is no relation between 5 and 36. That means in 5 table 36 is not coming. Now just see here what is the relation between 6 and 42. Here in 6 table we have 42. How many times? 7 times. So we can write or we can start as 5/36 plus 6/42. 6 ones are 6, 6 sevens are 42. So we can write this as 5/36 plus 1/7. Now children, here this 6/42 we have reduced to 1/7. Now easily what we can do, we can easily cross multiply. So how we can cross multiply? 5 multiplied by 7 plus 1 multiplied by 36 multiplied by 7. So what we get is 5 sevens are 35 plus 136 are 36 upon 6, 7, 6 are 42, carry 4, then 7, 3 is 21, 21 plus 4 is 25. So here we get 35 plus 36 is 71, 71 upon 252. So therefore our final answer is 5/36 plus 6/42 is equals to 71 upon 252 is our final answer. Now students, our next second sub question is 1, 2/3 plus 2, 4/5. Now here these two are in the form of mixed fractions. So first what we have to do is we have to convert it into simple fraction. So we can start as 1, 2/3 plus 2, 4/5. So what we can do, how we can convert? 1 3 is 3. Let me write 1 multiplied by 3 plus 2 upon 3 plus 2 multiplied by 5 plus 4 upon 5. Okay, children, what I did? I multiplied this 1 with 3, then I added this 2. That is 1 3 is a 3 plus 2 upon 3 plus 2 multiplied by 5 plus 4 upon 5. So the next step what we get is 1 3 is a 3, 3 plus 2 is 5. So we get 5 upon 3 plus 2 5 is a 10, 10 plus 4 is 14, 14 upon 5. Now children, in order to carry out here, the denominators are not same. So what we can do, we can cross multiply this. Okay. So how we can cross multiply? We multiply 5 with 5 plus this 14 with 3 upon 3 multiplied by 5. So what we get is 5 5 is a 25 plus 14 3 is a is 42 upon 3 5 is a 15. So finally what we get, 2 plus 5 is 7 and 2 plus 4 is 6. We get 67 upon 15. Therefore our final answer is 1 2 upon 3 plus 2 4 upon 5 is equals to 67 upon 15 is a 17 plus 13 upon 19. Children, in order to carry out the addition as your usual, the denominator here we have 17 and here we have 19. They are not same. So what we can do, we can go for cross multiplication. So let me start as solution. 11 upon 17 plus 13 upon 19. Okay. So the next step what we can do is, I can cross multiply. That means 11 multiplied by 19 plus 13 multiplied by 17 the whole upon 17 multiplied by 19. Okay children, very simple. So this is the way, 11 into 19 plus 13 multiplied by 17 the whole upon 17 multiplied by 19. So now what we have to do, we have to multiply this. So we have 11 19 is how much, let me check. 9 ones are 9, 9 ones are 9, 1 1. So here 9 10 carry 1 2. So what we get is, we get 209 plus, and for this 13 7s are, let me check, 3 7s are 21 carry 2, 7 9 3 1. So we have 1 12 carry 1. So we get here 221. Okay, 13 7s are 221 the whole upon 17 19s are, 9 7s are 63 carry 6, 9 1s are 9, 9 plus 6 is 15, 7 on the 7, 1. So here we have 3, 12 carry 1, here 3. So we get here 323. We have 323. Okay children, now let me add this 209 plus 221. 9 plus 1 is 10, carry 1. So here 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 2 is 3. Then 2 plus 2 is 4. So we have 430 upon 323 is our final answer. So therefore we get, we can write final answer as 11 upon 17 plus 13 upon 19 is equals to 430 upon 323 is our final answer. Okay children. Now students, our fourth sub question is 2 3 upon 11 plus 1 3 upon 77. Now they are in the mixed fraction children. So in order to carry out the addition, we have to convert first into simple fraction. Okay. So let us see how we start. So solution, 2 3 upon 11 plus 1 3 upon 77. So we get here 2 into 11, that is 2 11 to 11 plus 3 upon 11 plus 1 into 77 plus 3 the whole upon 77. So what we get is 2 11 is 22, 22 plus 3 is 20. 5 25 upon 11 plus 177 is 77. 77 plus 3 is how much children? 80. 80 upon 77 children. Now one thing we can do, we can either do cross multiplication children. See here, we don't have, here we have 77 at the denominator and here we have 11. Okay, we can also do cross multiplication, or one thing you can do children, this 11 we can convert into 77 by multiplying with 7. 11 7s is 77. So what I can do is children, this is also one more method here, it is multiply with 7. In the same way, multiply 7 in the numerator also. Okay, so now what we will get, 25 7 is how much? It is 175 upon 77 plus 80 upon 77. Now you can see denominators both are same. So now we can directly add this. It is 175 plus 80 the whole upon 77. Now here we have two denominators are same. So we are going to write only one time. Okay, don't add the denominators. Why? Because they are common. Okay, so what is 175 plus 80? What we get is 5 plus 0 is 5. 7 plus 8 is 15. Carry 1. So we get 255 upon 77. So therefore our final answer we get is 2. 3 upon 11 plus 1. 3 upon 77 is equals to 255 upon 77 is our final answer, children. Okay.